If you think about it, life has evolved to adapt to the second most abundant gas in the environment, that is oxygen, but not the gas that is the most abundant in the atmosphere, which is nitrogen. That's little odd. 78% of the atmosphere is made of nitrogen, while only 20% of the atmosphere is oxygen. So why has life on Earth evolved to depend on oxygen instead of nitrogen? That's because nitrogen is inactive, which means it doesn't react with things very easily. If you go a little deeper, when one nitrogen atom bonds with another nitrogen atom to form the nitrogen gas, they are bonded by a covalent triple bond. The thing about this sort of bond between two nitrogen atoms is that it's extremely difficult to break. Oxygen, on the other hand, is very reactive and can therefore be used in many biochemical processes that support life on Earth. That's why oxygen naturally becomes the supporter of life despite not being the most abundant gas on Earth. But to understand how oxygen became the life supporter gas, we need to go back to 2.45 billion years ago. It's not like life on Earth always depended on oxygen. The Earth was not how it is now, at least in terms of the kinds of gases it had in its atmosphere back then. There were no insects, no animals, and not even plants. Most of life was in the form of microorganisms like bacteria and was mostly limited to the oceans in those days. The primitive microbes that thrived in that period lived the real old-fashioned way. They were anaerobic, meaning they metabolized their food without using oxygen. But then a newbie appeared, and everything changed for life on Earth. This newbie came in the form of tiny organisms known as cyanobacteria or blue-green algae. These cyanobacteria started converting sunlight into energy and released oxygen as a byproduct. In more specific words, they were photosynthetic. So what occurred 2.45 billion years ago that enabled cyanobacteria to take over? Back then, our atmosphere didn't have as much oxygen as it does today. The little oxygen that our planet did have was either bonded with minerals or locked up within water molecules. As cyanobacteria flourished, the supply of oxygen on the planet increased exponentially. The vast majority of anaerobic bacteria, for whom oxygen was toxic, began to die due to this brutal rush of oxygen in the atmosphere. It was then that other more complex forms of life, including animals and humans, started evolving, thereby making oxygen the fuel source. Thanks for watching, and I'll appreciate if you can subscribe.